What's up, guys? Tukey here, back again. This is episode 3 of my franchise mode series with the Hartford Whalers. And let's get right down to business, shall we? Because we have to wrap up this first off season. Episode 4 is when we will finally begin simming through our very first season. Now, again, and actually, before we even get into signing people, the last episode was very eventful with the way that we set up the trading block. Again, we moved a lot of pieces out that we took in the expansion draft. So we are absolutely going to have to sign a lot of players, but I did want to take a look to see if there were, if there were any other moves that were made that didn't include us, which might be a rarity. And indeed, there is one there immediately. Thomas Hickey ended up being moved from the Islanders anyway, along with a fifth round pick for St. Louis's second next year. The rest of these pretty much involve us. Tampa acquired Vadim Shipachov from Vegas for a first-round pick and defenseman Ben Thomas. That first-round pick was next year. Anything else, or is it all us? I think it's all us, baby. I think it's all us at this point. No, there was a minor deal there. Florida acquired Kevin LeBanc, or is it LeBanch? I don't know. I'm going to say Kevin LeBanc. And a sixth-round pick in exchange for Colton Skeevier. That's a robbery by Florida. And that was the very first trade. So there you go. In case you forgot all the trades that we made in the last episode, you got to look at them once again. So let's do this, shall we? Let's see if we can manage to re-sign a lot of these players, most of whom are probably not going to want to stay here after the moves that we made. Now, Malcolm Subban's only looking for a one-year deal. I'm going to bump that up to 800K. One-way deal as well. 1 year, one way, which is fine. We might end up moving him. We'll see if he progresses during the season. Kevin Shattenkirk. Now, the 85% trick does work. He's looking for 4.6 over 4 years, which isn't terrible. But I could offer him a one-year deal. I could offer him a one-year deal and try to move him on as well at the trade deadline, which is probably the best way to handle it. So I'm going to bump this up to $5 million for one season, and then we'll probably try to trade him later on. Same thing with Stone. I'm going to move that down. I'm going to give him 4.25 for one season. We'll look to trade him as well. Ville Poka has to be signed, and hopefully he can progress fairly well in his first season. As far as Liljegren goes, we'll end up signing him, just not yet. Right wings, downtown Connor Brown. Looking for a one-year deal. I'll bump that up to 1.5. There's a good chance. I mean, he might get traded. He is 23, though. He could be a part of the core. Tommy Wingles. I'm going to give him a one-year deal as well. Somebody else that we could look to trade. Left wing, Scott Laughton. Could be a part of the future. Here, I'll just give him what he wants, see what he thinks. 85% trick, again, does work, but not really a necessity when you have like $40 million in cap space. We'll sign Gouts. How about 1.1? Over 1 year, and then centers, just Chris Tierney. Looking for 3 years, I'll make it an even $2 million for you, buddy. What do you think? And of course, Nolan Patrick has to be signed, and you know what? I'll sign him right now. I'll sign him right now. Nolan Patrick is going to be back in the fold. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. Love it. Absolutely love it. But again, who knows? He might be traded. He might be traded if we get the right offer. I'm not committing to anybody moving forward. Stone accepts. Wingles rejected. Tierney is back. Brown, Gounce, Shattenkirk rejected. Laughton accepted. Subban, Poka, Patrick. Okay, so like I thought we would. Right now, Kevin Shattenkirk and Tommy Wingles, two veterans, are certainly going to give us a little bit of trouble. I don't want to lose them for free. So let's just go ahead and again say 1 year, and how about 5.8 million for one season? You should still be tradable with that number. And then Tommy Wingles, how about 1 year at 2.5? That might be a tough contract to trade, but at the very least, we'd hold on to him for one more season. So it's a win-win if we can get him to accept that deal. So let's see, we'll advance day here and see what happens. Wingles accepted, Shattenkirk accepted. There we go. Don't play hardball with me. You'll just end up making $1.5 million more than you wanted. That is what we have learned here today. Now the trading block, I will leave the way it is as we check the free agent list, and then I'll upgrade it as we move along. So some interesting names there. Niederreiter, Tyler Johnson, No major game changers. How about goalies? Just Miller, Grubauer as well. So again, nobody incredible. Forsberg and Allmarker there, though. But let's take a look. Indeed, Vevalainen and Marmanlund are there, just as I thought they would be. And while it's a little bit predictable, I'm going to be cheap and sign them, because why not? So Vevalainen and Marmanlund. I mean, why pass up on two good goalies for the future? Again, Grubauer, I'm not going to bother with. Sandstrom, 56 overall, so no thank you. I think for our fifth goalie down in the AHL, kind of our backup level goalie, we'll just end up signing one of our draft picks, because there really isn't anybody here. Carletta wasn't bad. But yeah, I'd rather go with one of our other picks. On defense, what do we have? What do we have? Justin Schultz is a UFA. Right. Let's take a look here. He is pretty much the gem of this free agent class. I'm going to be a little bit cheap. Again, I'm going to go for a one-year deal. I'm going to offer him 5.8 for one season. It's not what he wants, so we could still decline, especially because we suck. But if he does accept, then we'll trade him to a contender at the deadline. Like I said, there's a good chance he might not accept, but I have $30 million in cap space. I have to spend it somehow. And he would be that extra defenseman that we could use in our top six. As far as prospects go, Slater Cuckoo's an RFA. What would it take to hold on to him? I'd have to offer him, I think, a one-way deal, which is fine. And say I offer you 125, would that cost me anything? No picks. All right, so there we go. We'll go after Slater Cuckoo. We'll also go after Johansson, who I, you know, rightfully assumed would be on the free agent list. Olofsson's a little bit underrated, but you know what? We'll still try to sign him up for the year. And I think that's pretty much it. High seventh. Kulak is there. Pelech is there as well. You know what? Let's go for him. We need bodies at this point. 1.1 over 1 year for Kulak. Adam Pelech as well. At least wants a two-way deal. That's helpful. And Seeloff, I mean, we don't need anybody assaulting teammates in practice, so we'll hold off on signing him. And then 7th D potential, I'm going to avoid for the most part. Although high AHL potential might be worth it. Let's go take a look. Although, again, 7th D potential now does have a little bit more value. Carrick is there. Trevor Carrick. You know what? You'll be the experiment. We'll see. We will see. He will be our experiment. Our guinea pig. To see if high AHL potential works out. Linus Arneson's there as well. Darren Radish is there, but his overall is a little bit low. Okay, I think that works for defensemen. Forward, prospect-wise, Burakovsky. Yeah, there's really nobody prospect-wise. Here, let's just sort by all forwards. Burakovsky, of course. Sorella, I mean, his overall's low, and low enough that he'll probably never progress, but considering teams want him, I imagine he'll have trade value. And then medium nine, again, we're looking at the ages. Brendan Leipzig, why not? I mean, Vegas wasn't able to get a deal done for him, and I wouldn't have to give up any picks. I just noticed he was an RFA, though, so they'll definitely retain him. Olsen, we'll try to sign him up. And that's pretty much it. So we could afford to try and splash a little bit more cash here, and we will do that. Tyler Johnson, how does $6 million over 1 year sound? You're not exactly going to a contender, though. Same deal for Tomas Tatar. Again, is this a little bit cheap? Maybe, but there's no guarantee that they're going to accept, because I'm not offering them the years that they want at all. Am I going a bit ridiculous with the money? Sure. You guys can let me know in the comment section if you think it's a cheap strategy, but it's pretty much our only advantage. It's pretty much our only tool. And again, yeah, I'm not giving them the years that they want, but God, why would you? They're all terrible. Like, they're all just awful. And those are the only two that I'll send an offer to right now, along with Schultz. And we will move forward a day, and or a couple of days, to see if we get any feedback. So let's find out. Still no. Wow, normally by the third day. There we go. Now people are starting to respond. Johansson is here. Marmanlund, Olsen, Vevalainen, Sorella have all accepted. How many contracts are we up to now? What is it, like 20? Maybe 30 tops? We have $30 million in cap space. 28 contracts. We don't even have 30 contracts at this point. Oh my God. That is how many players we managed to get rid of. We have less players now than when we did the expansion draft. Puts it into perspective. We'll send the next day. Tatar accepted. Pelech. Schultz. Tyler Johnson declined. So see, it can still happen. Even though I offered him quite a bit of money, Johnson declined. Leipzig accepted. Carrick, Olofsson, Kulak, Slater, Cuckoo declined as well, even though I offered him a one-way deal and a lot more money than what Tampa could have offered him. So there you go. We didn't get everybody. At least the players who were like, oh yeah, sure, I'll take the payday, like Thomas Tatar. That gives us some pieces to be able to trade heading into the deadline next year. So we still need 16 contracts, and we have $19 million in cap space, which is pretty ridiculous. Now, again, defensively, and actually I shouldn't have left that screen, defensively, I think we're fine. We have our six. Indeed, we do. We have our six with Kulak as a defensive D-man. Johansson's pissed for some reason. We do still need depth players, so let's sign Liljegren. Can I sign Gawanke? He was the German, right? He was the German. Boyer, McIntyre. Okay, so none of these, all of these guys can be signed. Yeah, so that's exactly what I'll do, I think. Let's see. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need to sign two of them. We'll go for McIntyre and Crosby. They might not play. I can actually guarantee they won't play. But they'll be on the bench. They'll get experience. It's fine. So on defense, we're good. Now it's just the forwards, which again, we are just terrible. Just terrible. Nolan Patrick's the depth guy by default. How many players do we have here? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right, so that's our 12. Yeah, that's our 12, as bad as it is. That is our 12 heading into this season. I really can't afford to bring in another NHL-ready player. As it is, Gaunt isn't even going to be in the lineup. So we need to sign, again, more depth players. And I can sign these three here. Let's sort by potential really quick. So Dirksen was the American. We'll sign him up, no question. We'll go for Kosarenkov. Kosarenkov. We'll get it eventually. We'll go for Davidson as well. And, I don't know, the low top nine players, I'm not sure. Marshall Coil, I just flat out don't want to sign. I don't think he'll ever progress. I mean, so I can sign them or I can make the AHL team better with depth signings from the free agent list. And that's what I'll do. We'll find half-decent players to at least make that team better. Maybe somehow they might make the playoffs. I doubt it, but it could happen. And as it is, I'm going to fix up the trading block again like I did before, and we'll see if we get any offers here. But forwards. So we'll look for the highest overall players who are minor league players. Not even depth. Actually, depth players might not be too bad. I'll just go for minor league players just so I make sure that I can make sure that they won't complain about ice time. Is that Dick Axelsson? It is Dickie Axelsson. I might have to sign him. Matt Fratton's a depth guy. Is that Ryan Jones? Could bring Ryan Jones back to America. Yeah, let's sign Ryan Jones. 1 year, perfect. Here, you know what? I guarantee people will say, why didn't you sign him? Let's see if we can bring in Dick Axelsson. And James Wright, former Winnipeg Jet, will pass. Steven Ryan Precht, the 41-year-old veteran, will bring him in. And can we find one more guy just in case? Tedenby? Nah. Sunkvist, Michael Chaput, Jerry D'Amigo. I'm going to look for a veteran. Shane Doan, Cullen. Basically looking for a name that I recognize. Pavel Datsyuk. I'll hold off on signing him. Who else do we have here? Vernon Fiddler. Is that Nicholas Hagman? That is Nicholas Hagman. Wow. Right. Actually, to be honest, Now, see, I've of course played the mode on stream before the YouTube series would have been going up. Occasionally, when you try to offer somebody, like what we did in NHL 17 a lot, is like a one-way deal, and we'll just offer you a shitload of money to help take up cap space. When I tried to do that on stream, it didn't let me, and it reset it automatically to a two-way deal. So I'm a little bit afraid to find out if that's going to happen again. And here, you know what? I should have been going the other way the entire time. Even then, that doesn't take up all the cap space. I'll drop it from 15. Let's say 11. We'll go for 11 million as a nice severance package to Nicholas Hagman, and we'll see if it resets back to a two-way contract. So there we go. I'm sending out four contracts, trying to get in some depth players to the squad, and we'll see what happens. Hopefully, they answer relatively quickly. What are we dealing with? What are we doing? Is anybody going to accept? Maybe. Yes, please. No, maybe so. Leipzig, of course, is going to stay with Vegas. No surprise there. Hagman accepted, as you would expect. It's just the question of did it reset his contract? Which, again, has happened before. We'll be able to tell by the cap space. It did. See? $20 million. So, one of my main weapons for dealing with the cap has been taken away. And I'm not sure if that's a glitch or if EA did it intentionally. If they did it intentionally, then they did it to make my series more difficult, which, fair play. Fair play. Because I don't see how anybody would have possibly complained about that. But yeah, it is what it is. It is what it is. Wow, a lot of players are pissed off, and I don't really know why. Nothing's happened yet. So for the moment, we have $20 million in cap space, which again is a problem, and honestly, it's going to lead me to have to splash some cash here for a player that we don't really need. So let's go. Dadnoff is there. So let's see. If I offer you a one-year deal, again, we have so much cap space. Am I allowed to sign him? I'm thinking it might be if they're asking for a two-way, you're not allowed to do it, but if they're asking for a one-way, you can actually do it. So I'm going to offer Dadnoff $10 million, $11 million. And of course, that means he's going to be impossible to trade. He'll be on the team all season, but that's okay. So we'll see if Dadnoff wants to come here for one season. That would leave us $9 million in cap space still, which of course isn't great. Axelsson, Jones, Reinprecht, all accepted, which is good. Can I advance day again? All right, good. So he accepted as well. What are we at cap space wise now? That is my question. Because again, this could be horrific for me if it doesn't let me do that. Okay, now we're at $10 million. Okay, so we should be fine. We should be fine. I have more players signed than I'd like to. Wow, Dadnoff is immediately pissed. What did I do other than give you money? I'm sorry. How dare I give you $11 million for one season? That's probably what you were making in Russia. Aren't you happy? But the trading block is the last thing I want to set up here before we sim to the start of the next season. And again, I'm going to say that pretty much everybody is available. Come at me with any and all offers, and we'll see if we can work out a deal. We will see if we can work something out. So again, we'll still go with the goalies. We'll say any and all picks are surplus, and we'll also be willing to take any and all picks. And we'll see what offers we get throughout the rest of the preseason. So the wants category, again, it sucks I have to re-edit this, but it is what it is. Only a minor annoyance. And again, we'll say anybody under 25. And let's go. I believe that would have been the medium bottom six. Am I right? Yes, I am. Good. Sometimes I actually know what I'm talking about. Only sometimes, though. Let's go 3.5 stars. Again, it would just be nice if it said the potential range that you didn't have to guess the stars, but hey, it is what it is. And I don't really need a goalie, so I'll just say any pending UFA. Why not? Why not? We pick up anybody now, we could just trade them along later on in the season. Now, I do have to be careful. If I acquire too many picks, the draft can still glitch. So I am going to be careful. Don't worry. And by the trade deadline, if I have way too many picks, I'm going to limit it down to about 15 in total. So in that case, I would have to start, trading for picks next year and being a little bit cheap. We immediately get an offer for Sprong that will decline, of course. Although a first round pick would have been nice, but still, It's Daniel Sprong. Oh my God, how can I say no? Ryan Pulock, Joel Edmondson, and Connor Brown for Owen Tippett. The game knows, guys. The game knows. Oh my God. I'm going to decline it just because I don't want to keep using the same players over and over. You guys know I love Owen Tippett, but I'll decline. Oland, Dempsey, and Olofsson for Brad Richardson and a fourth. I think Oland was low top nine. Dempsey was low starter potential as well, low fringe even. Am I right about that? Because if they're all low potentials, I'll take Brad Richardson. Why not? I did just sign Olofsson, though. I did just sign Olofsson, so I'm going to decline that. I don't want to get in trouble. Pulock and Oland for Andrew Cogliano. Cogliano. I could trade him for sure, and that would definitely work more towards. But again, Ryan Pulock, how much is he worth? I'm going to decline that. I think I could get a little bit more. Henrik Sedin and a fourth for a second, third. No. Glad to see Jim Benning still on drugs. Michael Stone for a second. Yes, that is a great deal, Tampa. Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. We were able to get rid of Stone. I will just go sign another random defenseman now to replace him until the deadline. And it might be somebody like Fedor Tuten. Let's take a look at all defensemen here really quick. So we got Postma, Paul Postma, Kulikov, Campbell, Ehrhoff, Mark Streit, Jared Cowan. I mean, it should be a 79 overall, so it's going to be one of these guys. Let's go. I'm going to go with Mark Streit. I'm going to go with Mark Streit. He's asking for a 3-year deal, and no wonder why you're still not on a team. Now, again, I have to be really careful here. To be honest, he might end up, you know what? He's going to be one of the guys that's going to be on the team all season long, and that I'm not going to be able to trade at the deadline. So I'm going to go. God, let's see. How much cap space do we have? I'm going to go up to 7 million. I'm going to go up to 7 million for this season. And unfortunately for him, he's not going to have a chance at another cup. He got his with Pittsburgh, and that's the only one you're getting. Here is your severance package. Enjoy your retirement because there's no chance in hell I'm going to be able to trade him. Holy hell. Backlund and a fourth for a first, Crosby and Oland. I don't need Backlund. Thank you. Streit accepted, of course. Oland and Olofsson for a fourth and a sixth. I would take it, but again, I can't trade Olofsson this early. I'll get in trouble for it. Oland and Dempsey for Blake Como. I mean, I could trade Blake Como. I could flat out trade Oland and Dempsey. I mean, Oland and Dempsey, they were both low potential, right? I mean, I could just tack a draft pick onto this or two. Let's see. Yes, I really did have value, by the way. A lot of people are pissed. Oh my God. Oland, low top nine. And Dempsey was a goaltender. Low fringe. You know what? I'll trade him. I'll do that. Let me see if I can get draft picks here from Colorado. And let me see. Can I get a fourth and a sixth this season? What do you say? How about just a fourth? How about a fifth and a seventh? How does that sound? How about just a fifth? Joe Sakic, you're looking to gift horse in the mouth. A gift horse in the mouth. I mean, I'm the one doing you a favor here by giving you prospects for Blake Como. You better accept this. Whatever. Take him. That's fine. I don't need him anyway. I'll get Blake Como. Flipping for picks. We're fine. Mike Green and a sixth for the Edmonton second. Absolutely not. Edmondson and Connor Brown for a second and a fourth. Now, again, both are younger players. What am I likely to get with that second? What am I likely to get with that fourth? That's actually a really tough offer. I'm going to decline that, though. I'm going to decline that. I think I want, Connor Brown to be a part of this team. A third and a fourth for Edmondson. I mean, Joel, I wanted you on this team, but they keep making decent offers, pal. I'm going to have to take that. I'm going to have to take that, which means I am going to have to sign another defenseman, probably Francois Beauchemin, to a decent deal. Arvidsson for a first. Arvidsson was he medium starter? He must have been medium starter, right? But he was a 50. He was a 50 overall, which means he is a ways away from being a half-decent goalie. But he does have good value. He does have good value, but it's going to take him a long time to develop. And Toronto, you know what? I'm going to take that just because Toronto might struggle and we might get somebody half-decent. If that's a top-five pick, I mean, it's golden. So I'm going to tack on a fourth and a sixth here. Pick hoarding for the win. Will that go through? How about just the... Actually, a fourth and a seventh might work. Fourth and a seventh might work. Will that go through? No. All right, just a fourth? How about a fifth and a seventh? Again, pick hoarding for the win. Will that go through? There we go. All right, so Arvidsson's off to Toronto, the goalie that we just drafted. Right? Like, here's the thing. I know we're technically pick hoarding, but that's what you do when you rebuild. Look at Vegas. I'm upping Vegas's expansion draft strategy to the extreme. I'm making all the trades they wish they could have made. Again, I can't trade Olofsson, so I'm not even going to look at that. Richardson in the fourth for the Minnesota third. I actually think, do I need another forward now? I'm going to decline that. Just in case. I have no idea what date it is, how close we are to being to the start of the season. I have no idea. Because obviously it's been July 23rd for quite a while now. Although we're not getting offers. So I have a feeling we're close. Yes, we are. All right, sweet. So we can set up our captains. Which, I mean... who are those going to be, right? All right. So I guess I'm going to go Shattenkirk, probably Brodin. Actually, Streit's going to be here all year long. And, I mean, why not? Why not? Nolan Patrick's our captain. Nolan Patrick is our captain. So let's take a look here at the roster, shall we? Oh, man. This is going to be ridiculous. Let's see. The goaltenders. Again, we need to sign another fifth goalie really quick. So let me do that. Let me do that before I forget. Hartford Whalers are a thing, though, man. We're back. We are back. And somehow I ended up with $6 million in cap space, which is hilarious. Goalies. Goalies. Let's go with Masiello. A little bit better. Sixth round pick of ours. He'll be our fifth goalie in case of injury. That's a decent little pickup there for us. Again, defensively, I think I have to sign one more person after we traded Stone. But we will take a look for sure. Of course, we are listed as a rebuilder, which is a surprise to absolutely nobody. And, I mean, two backup goalies, but we'll see how they progress. On defense, we have Kulak, who's listed as a depth, and Pulak, who's listed as a depth. Do you know? I'm probably going to give Kulak the chance. Is it Kulak or Kulak? I don't know. I'm going to give him the chance, though. And then when we inevitably trade somebody else, Ryan Pulak will get the opportunity as well. I do actually have one defenseman too many, at least for the ideal situation. But I'm all right with that. I mean, the ideal situation would be to have Ryan Pulak on the NHL roster. But we're okay. And then forwards, we have one too many listed. So JT Brown and Nolan Patrick. Right. That's a problem. I mean, I could just manually trade some players. I mean, ideally, I'd get rid of two players. And it would probably be somebody, you know, these third-line guys. So I think I am going to have to try to manually find trades here, which is fine. I'm just going to look at trading blocks. And to be honest, now might be a good time if there's someone looking to move picks to swap out some of those draft picks, because I guarantee we're going to have too many already at this point. And I plan on making more trades at the deadline. We are absolutely tanking through these first 2 years. So let's see. In 2018. Like, are people going to find it cheap that I have five first round picks? Are people going to find it cheap? I mean, I'm sure they will, but Like, what else am I supposed to do when I'm rebuilding? Just be like, no, don't give me the first round picks that are fair value. I don't know if people are going to find that cheap or not. They probably will, because anytime you have five first round picks or whatever, I'm not going to trade up. I can tell you that right now. I'm not going to trade up to kind of even it out. So the picks we end up with are the picks that we have. But yeah, as you can tell, actually, how many picks do we have? So that would be 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23 picks. Yeah, I need to do some business here. So forwards. The NHL level, JT Brown probably has to go. Wilson, and I don't even think I could trade Jamie McGinn. So let's try to get rid of DSP as well. Is there anywhere where I can send all three of these guys? Sam Steele's on the block. Are you kidding me? Right. Do you want to trade your picks at least? You do. Lovely. Actually, I'd love if you prefer to trade your picks next year. That would be awesome. 2019 picks right now would be more than ideal. But unfortunately, no one's looking to trade those picks next year. I'm just scrolling through. Does anyone have 2019 picks listed, or is it just 2018s? It's just 2018s. Okay, well, Colorado, though. Colorado, how about your third round pick next year? Now, I don't even know if that's going to go through, so I'll try to tack on that sixth. Will that work? It would. Okay, well, I wasn't expecting that. How about your second rounder next year? No. Okay, see, that's what I wanted, though, because now I can use draft picks to try to get that to go through. So how about the LA fourth? What do you say? How about another fourth? This time Nashville's. What do you say? All right, I'll use a third round pick. It's fine by me. How about Minnie's third round selection? And we'll try a fourth as well. It's going to be really difficult to get the second rounder, but that's fine. We have to get rid of some of these picks so that the game doesn't crash. That works. Okay, now what because again, I'm stingy. Seventh rounder as well, just to feel like I'm winning. Thank you very much. All right, so we sent those trio of players that we did not need out to Colorado. We were also able to clean up some draft picks for this year. I now need to call somebody up. That is Gounce. Perfection. That's good. I do need to sign some forwards, though, for the AHL still. Which, yeah, let's go do that. So really quick, let's go best lines. And I will hopefully remember to fix the draft pick situation at the deadline. And I'm going to wait until the deadline just because it'll be much easier to get a full look at all the picks, because we are going to acquire more picks throughout the season, I would imagine. Again, Tatar, Schultz, I mean, despite them being signed at higher, you know, higher value contracts, I'd still like to think we're going to be able to trade them. And there really isn't a forward. I mean, Gleason, Kaigordov. Yeah, I might as well. Whatever. Let's sign them up. Why not? What's it going to hurt? I'm not going to sign another guy, though. So I think, and you know what? Even then, it's worth going out and finding another veteran or two on the free agent list that'll hang around pretty much all season long. So let's take a look. You know, I'm not even going to look for veterans this time. Let's look to just see who is on the list to begin with. Again, James Wright is still there. Tedenby, D'Amigo, Bud Holloway, and Corey Conacher. You know what? I'll sign Holloway and Conacher. Holloway never quite made it in America, and then Conacher hasn't really done anything since coming back. Is there anybody else? Any names here that I'd really like to sign? Justin Hodgman, Kenny Agostino, Alex Bolduc, Taylor Lea. That's actually not a bad option whatsoever. So those would be the three guys. We'll sign them up. Before that, though, we have to set up ye old scouting rapport. Now, again, it can be very, very difficult to work, you know, to make this work. I'm mainly going to focus on just the CHL leagues. I'm going to go 6 weeks for forwards and defense from all three leagues. And that's pretty much how I'm going to handle it. Although, Actually, now that I think about it, the better thing to do would be to scout out the other leagues where there aren't as many created players. So let me check the rest of the world really quick. 10, 10, and 4. Let's see. Is there anybody decent here? How about computer generated is mainly what I'm looking for, and it looks like that is indeed the case. Are there any goalies? Not that I really care about goalies for the most part. Alright. You know what? Still, we'll focus on the other leagues. We will focus on the other leagues. So let's see. Say I do that for 3 weeks. 7%. No, it's gotta be 2 weeks each. Okay, so we'll start in the States forwards for 2 weeks because we are gonna scout the goalies as well. Let's move forward until these guys accept those contracts. Again, it sucks that we're in the Central. Conacher accepted. And the other guys, anything? Laier, Holloway, there we go. All right. Sweet. So the roster moves as we finalize this team, the very first Hartford Whaler team. Oh, we're so bad. We are going to be so bad. So let's go best lines and let's see. I mean, just to make sure the proper people are on the fourth line, I suppose. I guess no one's going to be on the fourth line to start with Lawton and Gounce, which is fine. Lawton has an 80 for faceoff, so we'll have Nolan on the right. And then from here, I mean, from here, it's one of those situations where it's like, just it doesn't matter. I don't think it does. So our top line, yep, our top line is going to be that bad. It is going to be that bad. I'm going to go with Tatar, Letestu. Actually, I'm going to go with Tatar, Tierney, Brown, Dadonov, Letestu, Como. Third line. Can McGinn play center? Not really. So whatever, we'll just have him on the offhand. Roussel, Wengels, McGinn, Lawton, Gounce, Patrick. On defense, I mean, at the very least, that's pretty much sorted. Schultz and Shattenkirk, Brodin, Bogosian, Streit with Brett Kulak. Right, and then of course the goaltenders, Joonas Korpisalo and Malcolm Subban down in the AHL. Oh God, how bad is this Connecticut Whale team going to be? Who is currently scratched that shouldn't be? Liljegren, that's who's missing. Also, McIntyre probably should play, but he is a little bit lower. Let's sacrifice. I mean, probably Olofsson. Maybe Olofsson. Right. We got some players that are going to be pissed. Yeah, let's scratch Olofsson. As it is, we've gotten plenty of offers for him. And we'll put in Liljegren. Right. And Carrick is going to be pissed about that ice time. Let's swap him and Pokka. And there we go. Defense is looking good. And then on offense, I mean, who's scratched at the moment? It did sign a ton of players. And again, I hate when it does that, as I have lost connection to the EA servers. Lovely. Well, let's take a look. Is there anybody here? I'm going to have to sign those guys eventually, which really sucks. Really sucks. But there's really nobody that I'd need to sign. So I think we're pretty much good. It's just putting the guys towards the bottom that don't actually have any value for me and giving that top line time to other more valuable players. So, the top six is kind of irrelevant. I mean, they're all just going to be completely awful. And let's see. We'll go with Kai Gordoff as the center, apparently. Actually, well, defensively, yeah, he's a tiny bit better. Is a tiny bit better. Do we have another right wing? Guess it doesn't really matter. Let's go Conacher and Holloway with Ryan Preck. So that, oh boy, that will do it. These are the teams for our first season with the Hartford Whalers and the Connecticut Whale down in the AHL. We are hot garbage, but by design. Again, this season we'll see if we can trade Tatar. Dadonov's here all year. Letestu, Como, McGinn, Wingles, Roussel. I mean, if there's still a lot of players I'd like to get rid of. And then, of course, draft pick wise, yes, we are going to have a lot of draft picks. That is what happens when you end up, going through the expansion draft and then immediately selling. So we are going to be hot garbage. But again, it is completely by design. Can I see the player ratings, the team rating from here, by the way? No? Do I have to hit play game? That's a shame. You used to be able to see the team rating. Can I see it from the calendar? What my overalls are? I don't think I can. No, I can't. But how sick is that whale logo, though, by the way? I like it. I love it. Anyways, guys, we don't need to drag on this episode any longer. That will do it. We have finally made it through the expansion draft, the entry draft, and the rest of the offseason. The team is set. Let the pain begin, starting in the next episode. So for now, I will say goodbye. Of course, you know what you have to do to support the video and the channel. Leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already. Links, of course, Twitter and Twitch are in the description. And hopefully, I will see you guys for the next episode with the Hartford Whalers. We are going to suck.